to live. Half time goes by, suddenly your eyes, another blink of an eye. 67 is gone, the sun is getting high, we're moving on. I'm 99 for a moment, I'm dying for just another moment, and I'm just dreaming, counting the ways to where you are. 15, there's still time for you. 22, I feel held to go. 33, you're on your way. Every day's a new day.
Words unspoken. Everybody, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may now be seated.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor as principal to welcome you to the 2016 graduation ceremony for Chestatee High School. It is a blessing and privilege for all of us to be here today to join in this celebration. It is without a doubt a special day, a day worthy of dignity and respect. These graduates have worked extremely hard and have made numerous sacrifices to get to this point in their lives. Therefore, I humbly ask that you refrain from using air horns and other noise-making devices. If you have a small child with you here today, please know that they are welcome. However, if they begin to cry during the ceremony, I ask that you take them to our special children's room located in the lobby so that our graduation can continue without disruption. An usher will be happy to assist you. I would like to extend a warm welcome today to our parents, families, friends of graduates, the Board of Education, administration, teachers, and support staff. The support from each of these groups has indeed made this day possible, and I am thankful that you all are here to celebrate with us. We have many special guests here today. Please join me as we recognize them. The Honorable Billy Powell, member of the Hall County Board of Commissioners. Mr. Craig Harrington, Vice Chair, Hall County Board of Education. Mr. Sam Chapman, member, Hall County Board of Education. Mr. Bill Thompson, member, Hall County Board of Education. Mr. Neil Yarrington, Principal, Sardis Enrichment School. Ms. Jennifer Kogod, Principal, Chestatee Academy. And on the stage, Ms. Christy Cantrell, Assistant Principal. Mr. Matt Stowers, Assistant Principal. Ben Corley, Assistant Principal. Michelle White, Counselor. Judy Lambeth, Counselor. Lorraine Cronick, Graduation Coach. Ms. Lee Wilson, Teacher of the Year. And Mr. Kerry Whitlow, Graduation Coach. Teachers, on behalf of the graduates, I would like to give you a special thank you for investing in their lives. Oftentimes, you don't get to see the real difference you are making. Today you do. Thank you for following your hearts and answering the calling on your lives to teach. The world indeed is a better place because of you. Please join me in thanking our teachers. Graduates, I count it a blessing to be able to share in this special day with you. Today, I want to spend a few minutes with you exploring the wonder of the number seven. The number seven is often called the world's most favorite number. It's had much significance in history, in religion, in cultures, and in ancient civilizations. As I explored just why this number seven is so special, I did what all good researchers do. Y'all taught me this. I Googled it. This is what I found out. The number seven is significant. There are 7 days in a week, 7 continents, 7 colors of a rainbow, 7 dwarfs in my favorite fairy tale, Snow White. There are 7 notes on the musical scale. Right, Mr. Merck? Good. And the opposite sides of a dice, if you add them up, they always equal 7. Some even say that breaking a mirror will leave you with 7 years of bad luck. While all these facts make the number seven special, today the number seven has another special significance. For many of you, I have spent the last 7 years with you. Not because it's taken you 7 years to graduate, but because I was your principal in middle school. Even if I wasn't your principal in middle school, we share a very special thing in common. That is, 4 years ago, we came to the high school together. So today, I celebrate with you as you finish high school. Unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, I'm going to stay a little while longer. Quite literally, I have watched you grow from adolescents whom I could physically look eye to eye with into young adults that I literally have to look up to now. I look up to you more ways than physically. Truly, you inspire me. I've watched you grow from awkward sixth graders, trying desperately to open a locker, into wonderful young men and women poised to make a profound impact on our world. I count today as a highlight of my life as I get to hand diplomas to a very special group of folks who will always have a special place in my heart. As we open the ceremony, bear with me as we continue along that road of the number seven. I want to discuss with you what I think makes you extraordinary. There are 7 traits that I want to discuss. Never in my career have I had anyone come up to me and say, "Ms. Sherrard, can you show me how to be ordinary? I'd like to just live an ordinary life and be status quo." Instead, deep down in all of us, I know we all of us, want to be extraordinary. To be extraordinary, ironically, just as the name states, you have to give a little extra. The first thing I want to suggest to you to be extraordinary is that you have to add value to others. You have to leverage your influence, your leadership, and your platform for the sake of others. I heard one of your classmates recently sum this up well. Reagan Puckett said, "Do for one what you wish you could do for all." I agree with you, Reagan. If I did for one, if Andrew did for one, if Taylor did for one, that would be a lot of ones. It wouldn't be long before we made a real difference. Oddly, when we add value to others, we also add value to ourselves. Think with me about Chick-fil-A and Walt Disney. Simply by going there, we smile. To add value, you have to serve. I applaud your efforts this year, students, as we participated in our inaugural service learning initiative. I'm very proud to say that Chestatee High School performed over 3,600 service learning hours. That is, you all spent 3,600 hours giving to others. Don't let it stop here. Continue giving. The second of the extra 7 I titled Create Value in Yourself. In order to create value in yourself, you have to relentlessly focus on always becoming more. Have an unquenchable desire to learn, read, and read some more. Listen to a podcast, subscribe to a blog, have conversations with people you admire. Find mentors, people who are successful in life, not just successful in jobs as society defines it, that is, with paychecks and corner offices, but real success. Once you find a mentor, talk to them and learn how you can follow in their steps. Consider taking a class, not just a class that you might ordinarily take, but one out of your comfort zone. Learn to do something that is hard for you. Malcolm Mitchell, former wide receiver for UGA and recent NFL New England Patriots draft pick, demonstrated this very idea. When asked what accomplishment he was most proud of, to the audience's surprise, it was not football. Instead, Mitchell said, "I am most proud that I finished the Hunger Games series in about 2 days." I know, Miss Gibson, that makes you smile. The interviewer, surprised, said, "Wait, but what about all those touchdowns?" Mitchell said, "Nope, football, that comes natural. That's a gift. I had to work to read." You see, Mitchell could only read at a junior high level when he entered college, but instead of accepting that fact, he set out to change it. He set out to add value to himself, and indeed, he did. He says now when people call him a nerd, he considers that a badge of honor. What a beautiful story of someone adding value to themselves. The third idea of an extraordinary life is what I call finding your why. Mark Twain said, "The 2 most important days of your life are the day you were born and the day you find out why you were born." Finding your life's passion is your why. It's truly a matter of heart. The older we get, unfortunately, the harder time we have following our heart because our head gets in the way. I say don't let it. Don't settle unless you find your why, because unless you do, true happiness will not occur. Unfortunately, in today's society, it is more common to find people who try to do less than try to do more. Graduates, don't be that one. I've read that by simply giving 10% more than everyone else, you will propel yourself out in front. For every action you take, push yourself a little bit more. Be led by curiosity and excitement. Find that thing that you find yourself doing regularly, having conversations about, or even being asked by someone else to do. When you do, you will likely be close to finding your why. The fourth key is to stay positive. Not only for you to stay positive, but for you to require those around you to be positive. That one's a little bit tougher. Everyone in life can be described as a bucket dipper or a bucket filler. That's you and I. Either we are looking for the positive in others, filling their buckets, or we are focused on the negative, dipping from their buckets. We all know who those bucket dippers are, even if that's not what we call them. Positive people focus on the solution, not the problem. Thomas Jefferson once said, "Nothing can stop a man with a right mental attitude. Nothing on earth can help a man with the wrong mental attitude." In order to stay positive, you must be intentional about who you surround yourself with. It has been said that you are the average of the five folks you spend the most time with. Recently, I went to a graduation ceremony at the University of North Georgia, where I had the wonderful privilege of watching two cadets take their commissioning oaths. In their oaths, they vowed not to cheat, not to steal, or lie. Just as impressive as they raised their hand, they also vowed not to tolerate anyone else who does. Given the fact that we are who we associate with, graduates, I think this oath is appropriate, not only for these esteemed soldiers, but for us as well. The fifth practice of extraordinary people is to be thankful. They are thankful for what they have, not envious of what others have. They are appreciative of what's good in their lives and look to improve the bad. They always find the silver lining in the story and leverage it to help others. I had the privilege of meeting Nick Wojcik. Maybe some of you know him. He is known as the limbless man. That's right. He was born with no arms, no legs, only a small appendage on his torso. Throughout his life, as you might imagine, he has had struggles both physically and mentally. As a young man, he questioned why he was born and what good he could possibly bring to those around him. However, through the influence of other positive people, including his mother, he learned to accept his position and use it positively to impact others. He is known for his motivational speeches, and he has quite literally changed thousands of lives. Though he was told that he would never stand, indeed he does. He uses that small appendage to stand, he can skydive, he can drive, and he can even draw using that one small appendage with no arms and no legs. Mr. Wojcik is the extreme, supreme example of the power of being thankful. Thankful for who you are, just the way you are. The sixth characteristic is that of being self-centered. To stay centered, that seems to be a little bit confusing. What I mean by that, though, is that this world operates in a dizzying pace. Don't get so caught up in the process that you lose yourself. Busyness stamps out creativity. It results in us acting in ways that we later regret. It results in us doing things that don't line up with the deepest anatomy of our souls. Graduates, take this advice as I take it myself. Put down your phone, take out your earbuds, turn off your computers and other devices, walk a little slower, sit a little longer, learn to like the silence. It is in the still, peaceful moments that we can clearly see, keenly hear, and better discern. The last piece of advice I'd like to give you tonight on how to live an extraordinary life is to build relationships. This time I really did save the best for last. Time and time again, research has shown that the number one predictor of longevity of life, happiness in life, and success in life is the quality of relationships we have with one another. People with fewer connections in life literally are also more physically sick. So quite literally, relationships really are the best medicine for living an extraordinary life. So graduate, I say to you, love big. In return, you too will be loved big. In closing, Nelson Mandela summed up what it means to live an extraordinary life. What counts in life is not the mere fact that we have lived. It is what difference we have made in the lives of others that will determine the significance of the life we lead. Simply put, graduates, our lives will be well lived if we have made others' lives better because of our presence. So, graduates, this is my charge to you. Create value in others. Create value in yourselves. Don't settle until you find your why. Stay positive, be thankful, remain centered, and build relationships. By doing this regularly, you will be extraordinary. You will be that tiny spark of light in a grand universe that makes a difference. After all, our very namesake, Chestatee, it means place of light. Take that tiny speck of light you've been given and leverage it to go far beyond yourself and bring light into the ends of the earth. Thank you.
Tomorrow's here, I will shout from the mountaintop, our hearts belong here. And we've traveled land and sea, the beacon, the love we keep. But when we
I would like to begin tonight by expressing my gratitude to my family for their support, to my cross-country family for many miles and many, many smiles, my friends for happy times, Heather White for showing me unconditional friendship, Ms. Lambeth for putting up with my neediness, my teachers for teaching more than just academics, mis amigos in AP Spanish for accepting me when I was the odd one out. And most importantly, I'd like to thank the class of 2016 for making these last 13 years a little interesting. So to start today, I'd like to establish and draw attention to an underappreciated fact. The universe is very, very big, and we are very, very small. Naturally, everybody wants to be a star. Everyone wants to shine and be seen and to be looked upon in awe. And some people are more driven by this desire than others. And unfortunately, when I started high school 4 years ago, I was the kind of person that let this urge consume me. Although I wanted to be as bright as I could in everything, more than anything, I felt that I could shine in academics. So I would slave for hours studying for a single test. I would fight passionately for every extra point I could. And I would agonize for ages over the way taking a single class would affect my schedule for the next 4 years, and the way that my schedule might affect my chances of getting into a certain college, and the way that getting into a certain college might affect my career, and the way that my career would determine the course of my entire life. Yes, this was my mindset, and sadly, it is far more common than you might think. And one particularly stressful night in the middle of swim season my sophomore year, the pressure of my obsession was really getting to me. A combination of mental strain, exhaustion, and plain old emotional volatility led me to tears in the middle of the pool. My coach and teacher, Mr. Greer, with the kind-hearted concern that is so typical of his character, pulled me aside to get to the bottom of the matter. And I don't remember the details of our conversation, and I doubt that he even remembers that this incident happened or how much it meant to me at the time. But the words that he said to me are ones that I will never forget. He looked me in the eyes and he said, "Abby, it's just life." And I realized he was right. I was being utterly ridiculous by wasting so much time and energy obsessing over my grades. Thousands of years of human history have come before us, living and dying and living and dying, and thousands of years are going to come after us. The story will continue long after we're gone. Living is nothing unusual, and so it is no cause for great concern. Because our lives are so short and so completely dwarfed by the reach of time, because we make up less in the whole of space than a single atom in our entire body, the things we do not matter except for the ways in which they make us happy and bring happiness to the ones that we love. Life simply begins, and it ends, a single twinkle in the night sky. So whether you made A's or B's, or you had 50 followers or 50,000, or you won or lost the big game, none of it means anything except for the happiness and the control over your happiness that you assign to it. So instead of striving for these arbitrary markers of success, we could be spending our energy elsewhere, making memories, serving others, seeking knowledge for the sake of knowing, pursuing our passions, and exploring every last corner of this universe, because it is a privilege just to wake up in the morning and be able to look out the window. I spent too much of my time in high school trying to outshine others, and that was time wasted. I know now that the most meaningful parts of the last 4 years were the ones that I spent with people I love doing things that make us happy. And that's how the simple words that Mr. Greer said taught me the most valuable lesson I've ever learned. And if you still need further proof that there are more brilliant things in life than accolades or awards, consider the fact that 93% of the mass in a human body comes from exploded and dead stars. It's pretty amazing. And it also means that we're literally forged from the nebulous remains of celestial bodies. We don't need others to look upon us and exclaim, "Oh, how brightly we shine," because we're stardust, people. We're but specks in this great, vast, unfathomable universe. So why worry? It's just life. And isn't it brilliant? Ladies and gentlemen, my good friend, my best chum, Andrew Hathcock.
Class of 2016, we dropped the ball. And maybe that's why the last 4 years weren't all that great for us. Or maybe it's that we should have gone to Chestatee. Chestatee seems like they had a lot of... I'm sorry, guys, this isn't my speech. I think this was left over from North Hall's graduation this morning, because we had a great time. Before I start, I'd just like to thank a few people. I'd like to thank all of you out there right now, friends, parents, families, for coming and seeing loved ones graduate. It really means a lot for us to have you in the audience. In particular, I'd like to thank my parents, grandparents, sister, and lifetime friend, Gary Martin, sitting there in the back, for coming here today and supporting me all this way. A huge thank you to Mr. Schofield and board members here today for supporting us for 13 years, and you've really showed us that you've cared about us and you've listened to us and responded, and we can't express our gratitude enough for that. And perhaps most of all, thank you to all you teachers, administrators, counselors, faculty, and other Chestatee staff here today, because there's no way any of us would be here without you today. And of course, thanks to Abby for giving that amazing speech and showing me up, as always. So we did it. 4 years, 197 Saturdays, countless hours of schoolwork, and far more Netflix than could possibly have been healthy. And now we're here, at graduation. And once we leave here, we have the rest of our lives. So let's do it. You got 1,956,528,000. Anyone have a guess at what that is? No? No one? It's the number of seconds we have from the time we leave this building to the time that some life insurance actuary somewhere says we may or may not leave this earth. It's about 2 billion seconds. That's a lot of seconds. So use them and make each second count. I'm not saying there's never gonna be downtime and never time to do nothing. Doing nothing is okay if you're trying to do nothing. there's always going to be time for binge watching. But it takes less than 5 seconds to tell someone to have a nice day. Everyone here, have a nice day. See, it was that easy. It takes less than 120 seconds, maybe, to make a lasting impact on someone's life. 120 seconds. Out of the 2 billion that you have, 120, you have the time. We have so much time ahead of us, so let's make it worth it. Every day, for the rest of your life, there are gonna be opportunities. Take advantage of them. If it's a networking brunch with friends, if it's a night out with coworkers, if it's a chance to go skydiving and jump out of an airplane, say yes, because why not? Live your life without regrets. If there's something you wanna try, go for it right now. Now, excluding world domination. World domination is in no way endorsed by Chestatee High School or any of its affiliates. I had to add that in, sorry. But don't think about doing something. Start doing it, then get frustrated doing it, stop doing it, quit doing it, think about doing it again, start it again, get frustrated again, stop it, and go on and off and on and off for the rest of your life. The road to life is paved with flat squirrels who never committed to crossing the road. In 80 years, when all the high points of life have passed us by, well, most of them, don't be the guy who sits there and looks back and says, dang, I wish I had done that. Be the guy who looks back at your life and says, dang, I did that and it was amazing. Now, some of the things you say yes to are gonna be mistakes, and that's okay. In the entire history of the universe, there has been but one person who didn't make mistakes. So I'm looking around and saying, as none of us is Jesus, we're gonna screw up. And we can learn from that. So when you do mess up, don't let it be a setback to your pursuit of life and adventure. Don't let one failure keep you from living life. When you say yes to something and it doesn't work out, that doesn't mean that the next answer has to be no. You can keep saying yes. Live proactively, make decisions, pursue life. Don't just be, do. You have 2 billion seconds, so don't waste them thinking about the things you could have done. So we did it, we're done. Except we're really only beginning. So today, pick something to begin. You may have already begun it, but whatever it is, find your passion. Find the one thing you care about more than anything else. It can be anything. It can be your community, love for animals, a thirst for knowledge, skill with engines, some mad accordion playing. And if you can't pick anything else, be like me and juggle and ride a unicycle. Because a backup career in the circus is definitely what my parents meant when they said, safety net. Whatever it is, find something you can continue for the rest of your life. Whatever it is, stay with it, use it, and make a difference with it. Commit to it. It's one of the big C words, right? The War Eagle way. Commit to it today. When you leave here today, go out and pick something. Find your passion and get busy with it. In the immortalized words of Tim Robbins and Morgan Freeman, you better get busy living or get busy dying. So get busy living today. Alongside whatever that passion you find is, pick a hobby. Find something you enjoy and you can relax doing. Use it to carve yourself out a haven far above the busybodied workings and stress of jobs and relationships and the rest of the world. Find something that you can use to get away from all of that and recharge so that you can get right back out there pursuing your dreams. Push yourself to be successful. Not successful by the definitions that everyone else has given you. Define success for yourself. Success doesn't have to be defined by how much money you make, what type of car you drive, or how many top albums you've released in the last quarter. Define it yourself. If success for you means having friends who are there for you and support you and always have your back, be successful. If success for you means having a husband, exactly 2.4 kids, a dog, and a white picket fence, be successful. Success for you is loving your job, having fun on the side, going to Disney twice a year, knowing you're going to heaven, breaking records, slaying dragons, or most recently, being rich, getting bored, and running for president. Be successful, whatever it is. Yeah. So earlier I said that the rest of our lives begin today, and that's true enough. But just because we're starting a new chapter in our lives, doesn't mean the book is closing on the you are today. Life is full of beginnings, but not endings. As we go on, the memories and experiences we've had over the last 4 years have changed us. We've been reforged in the heat of the crucible we call Chestatee High School, and we've come out better people for it. So don't forget high school. Don't try to live without anything you've learned. Don't try to just put it all behind you. It's too late for that. After the 119,577,600 seconds we've spent together, for these last 4 years, it's a part of you now. You can't leave it behind. So take it with you as you leave today and learn from all the things we've been through. Life starts now, but not the same way it started 18 and a half years ago for us. Now, we're prepared. And in another 2 or 4 or 6 or 8 or 19 years, when you graduate college or get married, have kids, retire, get a new job, move to Egypt, whatever you do, whenever there is a new beginning in your life, remember, nothing has to end. Just because you're saying hello to the future doesn't mean you have to say goodbye to the past. The you are today can continue. You don't have to recreate yourself every time life hits a corner. Just adapt. So class, use your 2 billion seconds. Change the world 120 seconds at a time. You have plenty of time, but don't waste it. Take advantage of the opportunities given to you and say yes more than you say no. Be successful, be amazing, and be you. And if nothing else, remember everything Abby just said. In closing, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and bring you peace forever and ever and ever. So that was about 457 seconds. That was about 457 seconds all in all. That leaves you with still a lot of seconds. So go out there and make them count. Congratulations, Chestatee High School Class of 2016. We did it.
Well, good evening, War Eagles. All right, now I've been watching you guys for 11 years, and on a scale of 1 to 10, that was about a 3. Good evening, War Eagles. Parents, grandparents, family, friends, faculty, would you agree with me that this War Eagle class of 2016 is absolutely, positively beautiful? Congratulations. Let me also take just a moment of personal privilege, and again, I want to thank Pastor Franklin and the folks here at Free Chapel for opening up the largest and the most comfortable venue in all of Hall County for our graduations. Thank you, Free Chapel. We appreciate your partnership. Now, class of 2016, I have to warn you, because on your program it says Mr. Schofield makes remarks, but let me tell you what my official job is and has been for the last 17 years as a superintendent of schools. I'm the old guy that has to do what's called conferring your diplomas, which means I'm the one who tells your Board of Education, yes, they actually took the classes they were supposed to, they took the test, they met all the requirements, and we can give them a real diploma from the state of Georgia. That's my official job. But as superintendent of schools, my favorite job at graduations is I get the incredible task of giving you the last lesson you're ever going to get from Chestatee High School. Isn't that great? Now, the older I get, let me tell you something. I'm well aware of what Thoreau said, and Thoreau said, never listen to the words of an old man, because the only advice he's going to give you is going to be in areas in which he's failed. And there's probably a lot of truth in that. So the more that the years go on, and the more that I have opportunities to talk to the generations that come after me, I spend a whole lot less time giving advice. And I spend a whole lot more time talking about truth. You know, in spite of what you've been told, in spite of what you've seen in your 17, 18, or 19 years on this earth, there is still truth in this world. And it is my hope, and it is my prayer, that it will be your generation that pushes this country that I love back towards the truth. That is my hope for you. There was a movie that many of you have probably seen before called A Few Good Men. And Colonel Nathan Jessup was my favorite character in that movie, played by Jack Nicholson. And he seemed to think that there were a few folks that had problems with the truth. Can you roll that clip?
You can't handle the truth.
Now, while Colonel Jessup believed that the people in that courtroom couldn't handle the truth, I believe and I know that you can. So as we spend some time together tonight, I want you to ponder this for just a second. I've read a number of different studies over the last 3 or 4 years, and the range of the numbers I'm going to give you are between 100 and 200. But let this fact sink in. Are you aware that the average American, tells between 100 and 200 lies a day? Now, I know those aren't Chestatee students. Those are average Americans. And class of 2016, we lie in all kinds of ways. Sometimes we lie with our words. Sometimes we lie with our silence. Sometimes we tell lies with our body language. Sometimes we tell lies just by the way that we live inconsistent lives. But as an American, I'm not proud of the fact that the average American is telling between 100 and 200 lies a day. It is certainly time that we give truth a chance again in our nation. Tonight, I want to challenge you and ask you to leave here, and this is the lesson with three truths. And the first truth, you've already heard it mentioned tonight. Your principal, Ms. Gerard, touched on it, and I want to say it again. And the first truth is, whether you believe it or not, the 6 billion people on this earth, each and every one of us has been created to do something absolutely, positively unique that only you can do and nobody else. And you see, that's a truth whether you believe it or not. Now, I can't hardly remember when I was 17, 18 years old. Seemed like it was yesterday. And last night, sometime when I slept, I got married and I had 3 children, and all of a sudden I was 40 and then I was 50. Life goes that rapidly. You've heard that tonight, and that is indeed a truth. But when I was 17 or 18, had I been sitting there and some guy with some gray hair would have said, hey, you've got something very unique that you and only you can do, I probably would have said, yeah, that's probably the truth. But how in the world am I ever going to discern what that is? One of my favorite authors is a gentleman by the name of Max Lucado. And I would suggest to you that a great summer read for a high school graduate is one of the books that he wrote called A Cure for the Common Life. It's also a good read for a 30-year-old or a 50-year-old or an 80-year-old. But in Cure for the Common Life, Lucado makes a point that each and every one of us was designed to live in what he calls your sweet spot. That place that you just know you're in the right place when you're spending time there. And the beauty of Lucado's book is he goes on to tell you how you can discern your sweet spot. So class of 2016, here's your last homework assignment. And she's sitting here saying, I love this because I don't get a grade and nobody's going to check it. But here's your last homework assignment. Please consider doing it over the next couple weeks. Get a couple blank pieces of paper and a pencil. As has already been suggested tonight, turn off your phone, turn off all the electronics, turn off the music. Make sure there's nobody bothering you. Get into that quiet place. Take out that first piece of paper and make a list of those things that you are good at. And let's just be honest. Ever since kindergarten, we know what we're good at. And we also know those things we're not very good at. So make a list of those things that you have discerned in 17, 18, 19 years that you are pretty good at and put it aside. Wait an hour. Wait a couple hours. Wait a day. And get out that second piece of paper again when you have no distractions and make a second list. And the second list will be those things that you're passionate about. And when I say things that you're passionate about, you know what I'm talking about. Heaven forbid if we got to set the alarm for 5:30 in the morning, we get up and we do something all day, and by the time we get back to our bed, we can barely lay our head on our pillows. But man, we'd just love to get up and do it again the next morning. Those are the things that you're passionate about. So you've got your two lists, class of 2016. You're going to have a list of those things that you're good at. You're going to have a list of those things that you're passionate about, and here comes the magic. Put those two lists side by side, and you know what you'll find? One or two of those things will be on both lists. That's your sweet spot. That's where you're supposed to spend your time. That's where I would encourage you to consider taking classes and getting degrees and getting training and reading books and choosing friends and taking part-time jobs. Make those decisions so that you get to spend more and more of your waking hours on this earth spending that time in your sweet spot. You know, you get to be my age and you start hanging around folks that are my age, and guess what? What I find is an awful lot of them have kind of this blank look on their face. They're just kind of going through the motions. They're just kind of going through life, putting one foot in front of the other. And what I've come to believe is most folks that are just putting one foot in front of the other are either spending an awful lot of their time doing something they're not very good at, or they're spending a significant amount of their time doing something they're not very passionate about. And if we're real honest with each other, I find a lot of folks my age doing things they're not very good at and they're not very passionate about. And class of 2016, that is a surefire recipe for the common life. Find your place. The second truth I'd leave you with tonight, and indeed I would ask you to ponder. And it's interesting that I call it a truth because I'm going to contrast it with a little lie that many of us that care an awful lot about you have told you since you were little boys and girls. I've probably told one or two of you in this audience the same lie. And here it is. The lie that we've told you is that great minds think alike. Nothing could be further from the truth. You know, you guys, unless you played the video game Rock Band, you won't be familiar with this music clip I'm about to play for you, but your folks will. Because there was a 1970s, 80s rocker by the name of Bob Seger. And he sung a song, and in that song, he challenged us to be different. Can you play that audio clip for me?
Feel the wind and set yourself the boulder course. Keep your heart as open as a shrine.
He's got Rock Band. And what Seeger said is he said, feel the wind. Class of 2016, feel the wind and set yourself a bolder course. Oh, how I would challenge you to question the direction of the herd. If you, figuratively speaking, are in a crowd of 100 people and 97 of them begin to go to the right, I would suggest you it makes some sense to consider going to the left. Living life by following the herd is not living life at all. Can you imagine what our world would be like if King David, or Queen Esther, Albert Einstein, Madame Curie, if they'd all just been content to follow the herd? Let me challenge you to be unique, to go your own way. The final truth I leave you with tonight is one that I've shared with my own children for over 20 years now. And it's interesting that when I take the job as superintendent, and I've done it 3 times for 17 years, you're probably not aware of this, but I actually have to sign an oath. And one of the things that I sign in that oath says that I'm going to treat you Chestatee High School students and the other 28,000 in our school district. The Latin word is in loco parentis. I'm going to treat you when your folks sign around as if you were one of my own three children. And for over 20 years, when I've dropped my kids off at school or I've left for work or I know that I'm going to be away from them for several hours, I always try to remember to give them this challenge, and this challenge has to do with truth. And what I say to them is what I say to you tonight. I say, guys, love the unlovable today. Show some care, some compassion, and some kindness to the least of these, our brethren. Oh, isn't it easy to love and be kind to people who are good and kind to us? But that's not the measure of the depth of your character. The measure of the depth of your character will be found in how you love people who are unlovable. We all know the golden rule. Treat people the way you want to be treated yourself. Can I take this opportunity to challenge you to live the platinum rule? And the platinum rule says, treat everybody you come in contact with significantly better than they'll ever treat you. That is the platinum rule. You know, George Washington Carver said it this way. He said, be tender with the young. Be compassionate with the old. Be sympathetic with people who are striving. And oh, try to be tolerant with both the weak and the wrong. For at some time in your life, you will be every one of those things. Love the unlovable. You know, I don't know about you, but I gave up TV about 15 years ago because I just couldn't find much worth watching on it. But when I turn the radio on, or if I open up a newspaper, or if I happen to be around a TV, it just seems to me that everybody in this country that I love is angry. Seems like we want to fight about everything. That we have to draw a line in the sand and we have to say, you're either blue or you're red. You're right or you're wrong. You're up or you're down. You're good or you're bad. Choose the issue. It seems like we're just angry. And another one of the hopes that I have for your generation is that you will push us back towards that belief that has made us the beacon on the hill for over 300 years, and that is, this incredible melting pot has always found a way for very different people from very different cultures with very different beliefs to be able to disagree without always being disagreeable. Oh, how we need to remember how to disagree without being so disagreeable. Now, that last challenge I gave you comes with a warning, because there are times to disagree. There are times to stand tall. And in your lifetime, I can promise you, you will have a number of opportunities to make a decision. And the decision will be, do I do what's easy or do I do what's right? I don't know what your issue will be, what your issues will be. Maybe it'll have something to do with your faith. Maybe it'll have something to do with your family. Maybe it'll involve your friends or something that just in the pit of your stomach, you just say, this just isn't right. But you will have those opportunities, class of 2016, to do what's easy or to do what's right. I've had the opportunity to watch you in the community you've grown up in, the kind of teachers that have poured into you and your families for 11 years. And I'm convinced when the Chestatee class of 2016 is faced with those tough choices, that you are well equipped. You will stand tall, and you will make decisions that are good and pure and noble and right.
Will you fight? No! We will run! And we will live!
Shame on you!
This could be the greatest night of our lives, but you're gonna let it be the worst.
And I guarantee a week won't go by in your life you won't regret walking out, letting them get the best of you.
Well, I'm not going home.
If
You've got too far!
And I'm gonna stay right here and fight for this lost cause.
A day may come when the courage of men fails, but it is not this day.
The line must be drawn here. This far, no farther.
I'm not saying it's gonna be easy.
You're gonna work harder than you ever worked before.
But that's fine, we'll just get tougher with it.
If a person grits his teeth and shows real determination,
failure is not an option.
That's how winning is done.
Believe me when I say,
we can break this army here.
And win just one for the Gipper.
But I say to you, what every warrior has known since the beginning of time,
you've got to get mad.
I mean plumb mad dog mean.
If you would be free men, then you must
fight to fulfill that promise. Let us
cut out their living guts
1 inch at a time.
And they will know what we can do.
Let no man forget how menacing we are. We are lions.
You're like a big bear, man.
This is your time.
Seize the day.
Never surrender.
Victory or death.
That's the Chicago way.
Who's with me?
Clap. Don't let team die. Clap.
All right. Let's fly.
And gentlemen in England, now abed. Shall
we? No, my name is the Lord. When I
tell our enemies that they may take our lives, but they'll never take
our Independence Day.
Mr. Vice Chairman, Board of Education, in accordance with the regulations and policies of the Hall County Board of Education in the state of Georgia, and on behalf of the Hall County Board of Education and myself, I hereby declare that these members of the class of 2016 have met all requirements and are therefore eligible to be designated as graduates of the best high school in America, Chestatee High School. Congratulations.
Andrew Clinton Hathcock, valedictorian. Abigail Blair Clish, salutatorian. Luke Christopher Grader, third honor graduate. Samantha Taylor Addington. Mackenzie Shirley Berger. Rebecca Braun. Amber Elizabeth Brock. Logan James Brock. Oscar Alejandro Campos. Sydney Christina Clark. Yasser Garcia. Glow Marie Lenata Garland. Luke L. Haina. Maria Fernanda Hernandez. Bailey Lynn Hooper. Georgiana Kylie Kohler. Kayla Alexis Croft. Natalie Nicole McNitt. Robert Zachary Morgan. Mallory Shay Myers. Emily Rose Parker. Reagan Elizabeth Puckett. Tatum Catherine Robinson. Jocelyn Jenneth Rodriguez. Hannah Victoria Shotwell. Trevor James Trimbali. Carla Isela Uribe. Christopher K. Zepeda. Gregory Anthony Aguilar. Isaac Alarcon. Brett James Alewine. Stacy Nicole Allen. Crystal Almanza. Jacob Michael Amelsi. Jonathan Aragwin. Jaime Arroyo. Zachary Chase Ashwood. Trace Thomas Austin. Susan Brooke Barber. Rodolfo J. Barcinas. Paul Alexander Boss III. Madison Danielle Beavers. Hannah Chloe Beck. Zachary Noah Robert Benavides. Najee Amir Boykin Whittle. Garrett William Brader. Taylor Edward Brandon. Brian Bravo Resendez. Sierra Caitlin Brock. Garrett Reese Brown. DeLorean Jade Brownell. Caleb Alec Brownlee. Katie Danielle Buffington. Kyle Aaron Burns. Riley Cole Camp. William Brandon Cantrell. Thomas Guadalupe Cantu Sanchez. Benjamin Brody Carlisle. Kelsey Rebecca Carroll. Christian Bryce Carter. Michael Thomas Cash. Jonathan Castillo. Logan Scott Cates. Ruben Cerda. Kristen Marie Chadwick. Mayency Chavez. Denise Chavez Martinez. Logan Grant Clark. Giovanni Contreras. Michael Cade Corbin. Joanne Corona. Esmeralda Cortez. Joseph Cameron Cruz. Alexis Cruz. Jose Yobani Cruz. Juan Jose Cruz Maldonado. Jairo C. Cuevas del Toro. Marvin Romeo Cunningham. Brandon James Davenport. Severin Charles Denergard. Trevor Allen DeLancey. Savannah Lee Dinsmore. John Garrett Dixon. Laritza Anna E. Demas. Doyle Wayne Dodson. Haley Marie Clyde Drum. Matthew Troy Dyer. Mallory Eberhart. Jeremy Tyler Enders. Jonathan Soren Erickson. Christina Escalera. Fernando Espinoza Soto. Edgar Esquivel. Rosie Alexa Esquivel. John Anthony Estrada. Aaron Bonnie Findlay. Olivia Danielle Funderburk. Edgar Omar Garcia Jr. Salvador Garcia. Hedwin Eduardo Garcia Bonilla. Colt Lee Gensel. Corey Lee Gensel. Carrie Brooke Gilbert. Lorenzo Antonio Gomez Mosqueda. Caitlin Renee Gooch. Logan Riley Gowan. Andrew Patrick Greeley. Mako Guerra. Brian Sean Harrington. Benjamin Scott Harrison. Emily Page Hart. Okay. Jacob Nicholas Hardis. Hasten James Haynes. Carrie Bell Hurd. Gabriel Hernandez. William Hernandez. Melissa Herrera. Naomi Adeline Huell. Tanner Elijah Hinchcliffe. Emily Caroline Hooper. Katie Elizabeth Hooper. Ashley Hope Howard. Brandon Cole Holtzey. Sierra Shane Humphreys. Logan Carrington Idle. Jonathan Robert Inman. Dakota Heath Ivester. Bethany Miranda Jackson. Francis Jimenez. Sarah Elizabeth Johnson. Arabia Gail Blue Jones. McKady Danielle Jones. William Connor Jordan. Eddie Hernan Juarez. Maria Guadalupe Juarez. Rachel Ann Julian. Jacob Matthew Kerrigan. Mikaylee Renee Lambert. Eduardo Landino. Michaelin Deanna Langston. Angel Jake Laracy. Devin Eugene Lavelle. Kimberly Lee. Casey Jordan Leach. Richard Lewis LeMay III. Madeline Christine Lesage. David Alexander Levesque. Levi David Labassi. Jacob Preston Lloyd. Danielle Loggins. Audrey Lopez. Brian Lopez. Carla Elizabeth Lopez. Heriberto Lopez Romero. Cameron McCade Lucas. Jose Fidel Lugo Leon. Tori Faith Lunsford. Taylor Elizabeth Mann. Paulina Manriquez Flores. Benjamin Martinez. Emily Martinez. Esmeralda Ruby Martinez. Jacqueline Karen Martinez. Jesus Martinez. Rodrigo Martinez Flores. Ansley Alexandria Mathis. Curran Michael McCarthy. Chandler J. McFall. Jordan LaShawn McKinney. Rachel Hope McNair. Michael Dale McNerney. Jordan James Meckwert. Marco Antonio Melendez. Bridget Nicole Menavar. Terry Joanne Molina. Jessica Fernanda Moreno. Austin Tyler Morris. Amanda Rochelle Murner. Bill Tran No. Caitlin Brooke Norrell. Edward Orozco. Jaime Ortega Jr. Fernando Ortiz. Shelby Diane Palmer. Juan Paramo. Charles Christopher Parr. Harley Jean Patterson. Alan Carter Peck. Stephanie Pedraza Hymus. Caitlin Elizabeth Perkins. Michael Joseph Pederoy. Madison Victoria Phillips. Jesse James Pischke. Savannah Grace Popham. Seth Richards Preston. Samantha Devon Probart. Jonathan Homero Rabadon. Alonso Ramirez. Sandra Maria Ramirez. Francisco Esiao Rebelar. Maria Celeste Jaimes Rebelar. Randa Brooke Reed. Carlos J. Reyes. Ruby Reyes. Augustine Reynaud. Amdor Mendoza Rhodes. Stephanie Nicole Richardson. Jose Rivera. Linda Rivera. Diego Rivera Valdez. Joanna Giselle Rodriguez. Yesenia Rodriguez. Grayson David Roaming. Charles Lance Rogers. Alondra Ruiz Ayala. Brittany Marie Rundles. Kuran Rashid Salam. Rochelle Salazar. Diana Vianne Salazar Juarez. Alexis Salgado. Alex Sanchez. Frederico Sanchez. James Michael Satterfield Jr. Aaron Wesley Salzgiver. Mackenzie Ann Scott. Osvaldo Guadalupe Silva Patino. Alicio Sotelo. Mackenzie Beth Staples. Corey Mark Stowers. Allie Mackenzie Tate. Glenna Mariah Taylor. Chance Alexander Thoreman. Christy Guadalupe Torres. Rebecca Lee Trim. Julissa Vargas. Galgani Vasquez. Jessica Vasquez. Tevin John Veasley. Esmeralda A. Ventura. Nicole Joan Ventura. Sophia Vitas. Maria Del Carmen Villacana. Kayla Nicole Watson. James Kenneth Weaver. Emily Elise Weeks. Kenyana Suzanne Nakia Wesley. Kylie D. Whitfield. Anthony Lee Wilkerson. Jackson Randall Wilson. Abigail Lee Zander. Jonathan Mark Yearwood. Maria Janet Zamudio. Congratulations, class of 2016. If we could all rise and stand as we join the chorus in the singing of the Alma Mater.
Rising with
As we come to an end to this ceremony, we are also coming to an end in a chapter of our lives. The turning of the tassel represents the transition from a high school student to a high school graduate. When we turn our tassels, we are starting a new chapter in our life. Now, class of 2016, please join me as we turn our tassels from right to left and start a new chapter in our lives. Congratulations, class of 2016. Graduates, as we close our ceremonies, I would like to remind each of you of your heritage. As a graduate now of Chestatee High School, you are forever committed to the sea, forever a war eagle. The words character, courage, and commitment, they are who you are, they are what we do. Eagles are known for their symbol of strength, their symbol of unwavering valor. Rather than cowering to adversity, rather than quitting when things get tough, they face storms head on, soaring until they come out on the other side. My sincere hope and prayer is that you remember this. As a war eagle, may you enter the next phase of your lives. May you face every life situation with the strength of an eagle. Congratulations, class of 2016.
Thank you. popping up the champagne. Pop. It's my house, come on, turn it up. Hear a knock on the door and the night begins. Cause we've done this before, so you come on in. Make yourself at my home, tell me where you been. Pour yourself something cold, baby, cheers to this. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and welcome to my house. And you know that you wanna stay. Close the blinds, let's pretend that the time has changed.